welcome here this morning to you who are here and you who are out there, and you who may be out there a little later in the day or in the week. Welcome to our annual Harvest Festival service. We come here, I'm getting my eyes checked in a couple of weeks. It looks like this probably needs to happen. We all fail to see things the way God wants us to see them once in a while. Come through a pretty tumultuous election season, may not even be over yet, and so we just come asking the Lord to forgive us our trespasses, to forgive us our where we've been rude or unthinking or mistaken completely, that he takes our sins and receives them, forgives them, and sets us free again. So merciful God, blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, healer of our every ill, source of our ending mercy, embraced in enduring grace and hope, let us turn again to God, confessing the truth about ourselves. Merciful God, we come before you, beloved but broken. We have not always treated others as we would want them to treat us. We have not always called out injustice and abuse. We have not always been kind to ourselves. We have not always taken care of the world we share with other living creatures. Remind us of who we are, beloved children bathed in your love. Renew us by your Spirit to live as your holy people, bringing healing to the brokenness around us. Amen. At every moment, you are held in existence by the love of God, renewed by the Spirit within and among you, and made alive again in Christ. Receive this assurance in Jesus' name. You are forgiven and freed to live for the healing of the world. Amen. Let's rise and sing Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace
pray. O God of justice and love, you illumine our way through life with the words of your Son. Give us the light we need and awaken us to the needs of others through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
And listening to a radio station where the mighty hosts of heaven sing. Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
touch with God.
In touch with God.
Turn your radio on. Don't you know that everybody has a radio receiver? All you've got to do is listen for the call. Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
Turn your radio on.
If you listen it, you'll be a believer, leaning on the truth that were never false. Get in touch with God.
Get in touch with God.
Turn your radio on.
Hallelujah, Lord, to whom shall we go? The Holy Gospel according to Matthew, the 25th chapter. Jesus said to his disciples, "Then the kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. When the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them, but the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight there was a shout, 'Look, here is the bridegroom, come and meet him.' Then all those bridesmaids got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the wise, 'Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out.' But the wise replied, 'No, there will not be enough for you and for us. You'd better go to the dealers and buy some for yourselves.' And while they went to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went with him into the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the other bridesmaids also came, saying, 'Lord, Lord, open to us.' But he replied, 'Truly, I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour.'" The Gospel of the Lord. Sisters and brothers in Christ, grace be to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. No doubt you've seen this graphic before, probably even here. You know who you are, whether you're the ones who run it as close as you can to the red line or the ones who are more prepared for the journey ahead and fill up a little bit sooner than the rest of us. I'll tell you where I land. Was probably over 30 years ago. I was working at a TV station in Dickinson, North Dakota, and took off on a road trip to do a news story in Belfield. Anybody here know where Belfield, North Dakota is? Raise your hand. Anybody out there? So it's about 20 miles south of Dickinson. And got on the road, and I realized I had not filled up the van. Now, this is a big Ford, you know, Econoline van. They don't really get really good gas mileage, and so I coasted into the gas station in Belfield, but I did coast. It could have been not so good because, well, the road between Dickinson and Belfield, there's not a lot of gas stations in the Badlands in North Dakota. And especially if I'd been traveling there at night, it might have been a little bit scary. Bless God that we were able to get there and get some gas. Jesus this morning tells a story about a wedding banquet, and 10 bridesmaids, 5 of whom were prepared, and 5 of them ran it a little closer to the red line than it was probably wise to do. This is not the first or the last time that Jesus talked about a wedding banquet. And in fact, in Revelation, we hear John describe Jesus as the bridegroom who comes. And so that's the situation here in Matthew. And the people who were listening to Matthew speak and hearing and reading his writing. To those, their plea was, "Come, Lord Jesus." See, when Jesus, just before he left, Jesus told his disciples, "I'm going to be back in just a little while." Well, that little while dragged on and on and on. The temple in Jerusalem, where many of Jesus' followers had worshipped, and Jesus himself, was gone. It had been destroyed. And so they wondered, when is Jesus coming back? When would the bridegroom return? And so it's in that context that Jesus tells this story about the wise and foolish bridesmaids. And Jesus is saying, prepare. Because you do not know when the bridegroom is coming. You do not know how long you're going to have to wait or how soon it's going to come upon you, this joyful reception and reunion that we will know when Jesus comes again. I'm sure this last year, as for me, has been one tumultuous thing after another, and between the fires and the hurricanes and the floods and the civil unrest and COVID and an election and disruption and everything that you can imagine, and it got to leave people wondering, well, is the end of the world coming now? Is Jesus going to return now? When, Lord? And we could feel like we're going to be waiting until our bones are dry. How long, oh Lord, are we going to have to wait? Our bishop, Constanze Hagemeyer, as we approached the middle of this pandemic this year. Said, you know, at the beginning we had kind of like a snowstorm and it was disorienting. But she said, I think we're probably more in for an ice age, where we never quite know where that ending is going to come. It's going to last a lot longer than what we think. And so, how can we be prepared? Well, one way is to get filled up, huh? To anticipate that long wait and find ways to fill our souls as we fill our bodies with food. And some ways to do that, of course, is through prayer and scripture, through worship and communion, through taking time to pass on the faith to our children. But just taking time to fill ourselves up, prepare for the long journey. You know, Elijah the prophet, when he was trying to escape an evil king and queen, and had just about given up hope, and God came to him and he said, you know, rest and then eat, because the journey will be long. The journey will be long. And we began way back in March, so the 22nd of March was the first Sunday that we went outside the building, went totally online with worship. And I, at least for one, thought, well, you know, this will be a few weeks, maybe a couple of months, and then it turned into Easter, and then it turned into fall and winter. You know, in the beginning, it was kind of fun. You go home and we do worship in different ways. So I did one worship service from our basement, and we tried some different things and had some fun. But after a while, it just kind of dragged on, and even I began to lose energy. And when is this going to end? As a congregation, you can thank your leaders that we have been prepared financially for this long haul through introducing online giving that took off as soon as people took off and went outside the building, through the payroll protection program that Carrie oversaw us applying for, and we received that, and through the faithful giving of people, just everyday folks who knew that the ministry needed to go on, and they continued to give, even though they might not have even been able to see or participate at all in worship here. They knew that the ministry went on. So we were prepared financially. I don't know how much either I or as a congregation we might have been prepared spiritually and emotionally for that long winter. Being alone, being separated, for some not being able to have visitors in the hospital or the nursing home. Even being separated at times of death. And so, you know, this last week we had a memorial service for Dick Llewellyn, and people were spread out all over the country. And I was here alone leading the service. Just a different time. And we don't know how long this is going to continue. If your fuel tank, your lamp, is getting a bit low, this is a time to renew, because we don't know how long it's going to be till we get another stop. Huh? You know how it is when you think, well, I've got enough gas in the grill, and then the whole crowd turns up and have nothing to eat. You've got 16 flashlights and none of them have a battery in them. It comes to a power outage and the candles are all burnt down. We're coming to the end of 2020, huh? And people are just waiting for this year to end. But you know what? When this year ends, it may not end all this that we are involved in. So it's time to relight the lamp, to refill the fuel, to refill the oil, to recharge and reignite for what may be a whole new world. You know, the flying cars that we talked about back when I was young, they're out there now. And they may be a real reality sooner than we know it. And I think this pandemic and what we've gone through is likely to put us in also as a church in a new reality. And so how can we prepare for that? How can we fuel up and recharge for that new world? As we come together on this harvest festival, we give thanks for everything that God has given us. Huh? The crops and the fields and the food that we eat day by day. The gifts, the abundant gifts of God's people that have arisen, even again, in the midst of chaos. Huh? And so we've been able to have people chiming in from far away through video and other means, and people lifting up their gifts that maybe had been unknown before and using the gifts that they use every day for the sake of the church. And so I really, as one, give thanks for you all here and you all out there who have shared your gifts with us in so many different ways. We don't know when Christ will return. We can long for his coming and say, come, Lord Jesus. And as we do, we can say also, fill our cup, Lord. Fill us up. Fill us up with your light and your love, that we may go forth and be light and love to the world. Amen. Let's sing. This little light, I'm going to let it shine. I heard the Sunday school was also rehearsing this morning. It's been a little different tune, a little different rhythm, but
this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. I've got the light of grace, I'm gonna let it shine. Light of grace, I'm gonna let it shine. I've got the light of grace, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it
it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
We've got the light of love, we're gonna let it shine. We've got the light of love, we're gonna let it shine. We've got the light of love, we're gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Let it shine as we confess our faith in the baptismal creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord,
who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he arose again, he ascended into heaven, he is seated at the right hand of the Father, he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Peace to the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Peace to the Lord be with you. You shared that peace with one another across the aisles or next door?
Peace.
So a few announcements for you. So right after worship today, there'll be a very brief special congregational meeting. We don't know what's going to happen come January when it comes time for our annual meeting, and so with the help of our synod staff and constitutional experts in our synod, there's a resolution before us to amend the constitution to allow for electronic congregational meetings, and so we'll talk a little bit more about that, but we're going to vote on that amendment at that special meeting. Following that, you are welcome to take part in the Women's Harvest Festival silent auction, the bake sale that's out here, to pick up a sack lunch to go with a free will offering. And I'm told those sack lunches contain a barbecue, some chips, and a cookie, and a bottle of water. So that is your to-go meal for today. Veterans Day service will be a little bit different this year. I think you'll probably see that announced in the paper, mostly online, with the veterans themselves participating at the school. But I'll let you refer to the paper and other sources for that. Next Sunday is the Legion Pancake Feed, so don't forget that. And also this thank offering, and Carrie will be up here a minute, so I'm just going to let her do that. Our companion synods, so we as a congregation, as a synod rather, in South Dakota, we have connection with two other countries, Lutherans in two other countries, Cameroon and Nicaragua, each of which have been suffering some issues. So Nicaragua, of course, was victim to, I believe it was Hurricane Ida. And Cameroon, there's been a school shooting that's been a result of some social unrest there. And so our prayers for them this day. Anything else I'm missing? Now I want to show you something. So back in the spring, we were looking forward to a synod assembly in June. And this is the 50th anniversary of the ordination of women. And so our women were asked across the synod to prepare a stole in celebration for that. And so our women here, Jean and Peg, along with Laura Kieser and Laura Baker, helped to create this stole. It was going to be used for Easter, so it's what color? White? You know, the acolytes just learned about the colors. But it's also going to be, probably going to be used on the 22nd, when we've invited Nancy Eccles, one of our female pastors, to come and preach for you for the women's thank offering service. And so it's for the congregation and not for me. So I asked the women to make it a little bit shorter than I am. And on one side it has Miriam, sister of Moses, who announced, who sang for joy when the people of God had come through the flood, the Red Sea, rather. And then on this side is Mary Magdalene, who announced the resurrection of Jesus. And so we thank all these women for participating, and the female pastors among us for giving us the opportunity to celebrate. Okay. Birthdays. I know we have a faithful watcher out there, and so I want to say happy birthday to Lawson Fagerhag, along with Kathy Larson and Mariana Borkowski. They all have birthdays on Veterans Day. Imagine that. And so please wish them a happy birthday. Okay, anything else I'm forgetting? Then let's go into prayer. Oh, yes. Okay. Back to the silent auction. It ends at 11:30 this morning. Please pick up your lefse that you ordered. So, and it was really good lefse. So, you're in luck if you got your order in. All right, let's pray. Longing for Christ's reign to come among us, we pray for the outpouring of God's power on the church, the world, and all in need. Us to deep praise as we gather for worship. Enliven our worship with sincere and heartfelt song. Sustain the work of all church musicians and artists who lead us in praise and prayer. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Holy God, surprise and delight us with the beauty of the world you have made. Help us as we harvest, hunt, or simply live within that beauty to act in ways that glorify you. Hear us, O God. Holy Provider, we give you thanks for seeing this congregation and us individually through the past several months. Fill our lamps, Lord, that we may continue to serve you as we wait for the return of the bridegroom, your Son, Jesus Christ. Hear us, O God. Holy Ruler, grant peace and mutual respect in the wake of the recent elections. Rule over the election process as it continues and in the hearts and minds of all who lead our nation. Hear us, O God.
Mercy is great.
Holy Companion, console us who feel lonely or abandoned. Share the hours of those who live and eat alone. Comfort those who have few friends or who struggle with their identity and place in this world. Hear us, O God.
Mercy is great.
Holy Advocate, come to the rescue those who are mourning, in pain, or ill, especially for our companion synod churches in Nicaragua and Cameroon, for Mary and Darcy, for Oli and Shirley, for the Wascota Manor staff and the hospital staff, all healthcare workers, for Sue and Jay and Dick, for Iona and Pauline and Betty and Elner and Lynn and Laura and Russell and Marion and Shirley and Jason and Erica and Conrad and Stephen and Jake. Hear us, O God. Holy Protector, be with us and be with all observing Veterans Day. Guard the lives of active duty and retired military personnel. Comfort all who mourn those who have died in the line of duty. Heal the wounds, both physical and mental, experienced by service members. Hear us, O God. Holy and immortal One, we pray in thanksgiving for the lives of all who have died. Remind us of the frailty and shortness of our own lives and inspire us to use them for the building up of your kingdom. Hear us, O God. Receive our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, until that day when you gather all creation around your throne, when you will reign forever and ever. Amen. Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, thy wings shall my petitions bear. To him whose truth and faithfulness engage the waiting soul to bless. And since he bids me seek his face, believe his word and trust his grace, I'll cast on him my every care and wait for thee, sweet hour of prayer.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. I told you I needed new glasses. I want to invite Carrie up here to do our thank offering presentation.
Community of faith and its ongoing effort to spread the word of Jesus Christ. Through your dedication, our Savior's Lutheran Church, we have been able to provide gifts that feed the hungry, care for the sick, and offer compassion to those who need it in their lives, so that the world may know God. Jesus' call to make disciples of all nations challenges us to continue to grow in spirit and service in this congregation. As a church, we are entering into a time of thinking about how we can help make and create a positive change. Each and every one of us has a special gift to offer our church, whether it be through music, learning, volunteering, to help with activities, and helping with anything that we feel passionate about within this church. This year, as a pandemic sent congregation scrambling to meet the worship needs of their people, God equipped this congregation with both the leadership and the technology to transition to alternative means of ministry. We ask that you join us now in prayer for preparation for ourselves and for the whole church as we move into the new year in these uncertain times. We know that not everyone will be able to give in response to what they have received, and that these difficult financial times present a challenge to some families. If each household increased just $5 per week, it would provide an extra $20,000 in resources for the congregation in this upcoming year. Please consider everything that the church encompasses in our daily lives and the importance of these to you individually. How different would our lives be without the work of the church? What would we do if we did not have the church to educate ourselves and our children about Christ and to touch the lives of those around us by God's word? As we look ahead into 2021, we focus on what we as a congregation can do to reach out so that the world may know God. As we move forward together, we ask that you take time to reflect on what the church has provided you throughout your life and how you can be an influence to others to help them grow in their faith through our Saviors. We thank you for your part in the life-changing work, and we are excited for the upcoming year and how we can all work together to spread God's word so that the world may know God. On behalf of the Stewardship Committee through our Saviors, we'd like to thank you for your continued giving. We hope as you complete your commitment cards, you'll recognize all the good things that our church has accomplished and everything we have to offer, and that you feel good about your giving to our church. Thank you.
Oh, no, I'm not. I shut myself off. One more time. So, whether you brought your commitment card with you, or if you just filled it out, take and tear it in two, keep the left half, put the right half in the basket as you go out. Yeah. And if you brought offering today, you may put that in the plate as you go out. And now, Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Last week was All Saints Sunday, but we didn't get a chance to sing this song, and I added a verse at the end in keeping with our gospel today. You may stand if you are able.
Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, Lord, I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in. And when the sun refused to shine, and when the sun refused to shine, Lord, I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in. And when the bride